Hi guys, it's Kelly here and I'm back again with another video. Today's video is featuring some products from Hero Arts and Altenew. So this is the pumpkin bunch. I'm using the stamps, dies, and the color layering stencils. And then I'm also using the holiday season messages bundle. I did not show you the leaf circle stencil until later, but to be fair, I didn't know I was going to be using it. So this card, let's talk about what I'm doing and then we'll talk about some giveaways and stuff. So anyway, I really wanted to use these differently. I've used these in the past, and I wanted to do like a more modern take, or where I feel like, you know, kind of what's more in style right now. I stamped this in antique ivory ink, but clearly my stamp was not clean, as you can see here. Like the ink reactivated the old ink, and so anyway, it doesn't matter. It's still going to end up looking no line coloring. But in order to get the look that I want, the stencils are created so that you color all the pumpkins one color. But I didn't want the same color pumpkins. So we're going to do some masking. And that's what you see me laying down there is Altenew's masking paper. I've just trimmed it to the appropriate size. I'm going to stamp it in that same antique ivory and get the same result, honestly, from reactivating that ink the first time around. Should I have cleaned my stamp? Absolutely. Did I? Absolutely not. Will I in the future? Definitely no. So you do whatever works for you. The Altenew masking paper is fairly sticky, so I do stick it to my hand or like my pants or whatever a couple of times before I put it on my project. When you're going in and cutting your masks, the accoutrements, the accessories on the outside don't matter. You just need to cut the pumpkins out individually. And so you'll see here, I'm just going to piece them back together so that I can color just that top pumpkin by itself. But you do need to keep the masks for all three pumpkins if you want to do all three of them different colors. So I put those masks in place. Here I was just showing you, that's the fourth or fifth stencil. I'm not going to use it. It's the one that gives them cute little jack-o'-lantern faces. But we're not doing cute today, ladies and gents. We're doing, you know, modern, antique kind of feel for it. So that's what we're doing there. I'm doing a cream-colored pumpkin, a navy, and like a teal. And we're going to go in, we're going to do it with the inks first. So this is that same antique ivory I'm putting down using my Hero Arts blending brushes. And then I'm going to add just a little bit of dimension, kind of where they're tucked behind the other pumpkins, as well as the top where the stem is, with some sand. And we're going to go through and we're going to do two color blends for all three of these pumpkins. If you are a person who is not a colorist, color layering stencils are a really great option. I would just recommend using more than one color so that you can still get some dimension. So now once that one's done, I'm going to go in, I'm going to remove the mask for the little teeny tiny one, and I'm going to put the mask on for the larger one. Something to note, sometimes if your paper is still wet, like your ink is still wet, your mask may have a little bit of trouble sticking. So you can hit it with your heat tool, or you can just wait a minute or two until it dries out. And then, you know, we're going to be doing the same thing every single time. So now, what about these giveaways? Giveaways, you say? So this is actually part of, and you may have noticed this just kind of across the industry, Altenew has been doing a lot of collaborations with different companies, which I am here for. I love when companies support other companies and that they're all working together. Makes my heart happy. So this is the collaboration hop for Hero Arts and Altenew, and they are actually doing it as a blog hop. There's so many prizes from both companies. I will link it below if you're watching the video on YouTube and you want to head over there so that you can participate and, you know, have your chances to win. There's a lot of wonderful, talented people on the hop. And this is open till October 3rd is what the last like comments you have on the blog. The comments on the YouTube don't count, but I appreciate them. But in order to be entered for the giveaway, you do have to comment on the blog. And then the winners will be announced on the 6th on Altenew's winner page. So that's that. That's housekeeping. And best of luck to you. I love giveaways and I used to enter them all the time before. But now I'm super blessed to be able to do this for a living. So I typically don't enter them because I don't have the same need as I did previously. So anywho, now that we have all of the base layers stenciled, I'm just going to take these off real quick so you can see them. So now we have three obviously very distinctly colored pumpkins, which I love. It adds more versatility to the stamp, which I think is great. I'm going to put my masks back in place now to do the next layer. The next layer is like the detail layer. And you guys know I love to leave in all of my boo-boos. And so I had to learn a little bit of a lesson with the cream colored pumpkin, which was I went in with my shading color, which was the sand, for my second layer, and it was a little too dark. Like, it wasn't a good transition. So if that happens to you where you're like, ooh, this is not a good transition. Oh, also I added a little bit of shading in those darker areas with Cup of Joe, which also maybe was a faux pas, but it's okay. We're going to fix it. I'm going to show you. So here I'm like, oof, this is kind of too stark. I don't really love it. I'm going to go back in with the first stencil, and then I'm going to go back in with this antique ivory and just do the whole thing all over again to really soften up that color. And then I'm going to reshade it, this time a little bit more sand than I used the first time around. And that's really going to soften the shading portion quite a bit. And then for the next pumpkin that we do, I now know, because I've learned this lesson, right? I now know to go in with my original color and just do another layer of color. So this time I went in with the mist, and this was a much softer transition, and I liked it a lot more. It just worked out better. And then I will still add a little bit of dimension with that Bermuda just at the top and the bottom. And then I will do the third pumpkin the same way here because I wanted a little bit of darker depth of color. This is the brush I use for nautical, which is navy. But I didn't pick up any ink. I just used what was left over to add a little bit more darkness. And then for this one, which is navy, we're using the periwinkle, the nautical. And so I'm going to go in with the periwinkle, you know, to do the main portion of it, add my shading with my nautical. And then for that little bit of extra oomph of definition, I'm going to actually use the blending brush that I have for my black. And then that I will use, again, I'm just using the leftover ink that's left on it, and that will just go in the darkest parts. And then the pumpkins are shaded. Now, let's be real. You guys know I can't leave anything alone. I think they look beautiful the way that they are, but I like dimension. So we are going to revisit the pumpkins. But first, we're going to do the leaves and the stems. So these are obviously more muted colors. Well, that, I don't know, that teal one's maybe a little bit bright. But these are, for the most part, it's a more muted palette. And so I chose some greens that were also more muted. I'm using the soft olive and the field greens. This layer includes the stems as well. I'm not going out of my way to avoid the stems, but I'm not going out of my way to add a ton of color to them either. Like, if they get some green, great. If they don't, also fine. Because I'm going to go in with the small size brush, which is really great for like detail blending, and make those stems brown using the Cup of Joe, which is one of those like Hero Arts revamped all of their colors in the last couple of years. If you follow them, you know that. But this is one of the like original colors that they ended up keeping, and I'm so glad they did because I really love this brown. I think it's a beautiful brown. But anyway, so I added the brown to the stems, and then we're going to add this detail layer. I went in and I added the details like I would if I wasn't using paste, just so you could see what it would look like. I like kind of didn't want to shortchange you on the whole shebang, but I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to leave it like this. I am going to use the paste. So I just went back in, same thing with Cup of Joe, did another layer of that, and then I'm going in with field greens, did another layer of that for the detail, and then once again, I will show you what that looks like. But I already knew that I wanted to do the gold paste. So I'm using Hero Paste here. They have a gold one. A glitter would also be beautiful, but I thought the gold with the muted colors would be really pretty. And so that's what I'm going to do. And the whole time, like, this stamp wheel is holding my stencil, no issues. Here, because I peeled it up and then I just laid it back down, it wasn't adhered firmly. So I just needed to lay it back down to be sure. But like I said, the sticky mat for the stamp wheel is holding all of these stencils. No tape required. It is by far and away one of my favorite aspects of the stamp wheel. So I just went in with this gold, scraped it on super lightly, scraped off any extra. And then I did, you know, take it to my sink to wash it right away. But I love the little gold details that this has added. And now here is where I can't leave well enough now. Do I think that these are beautiful? Yes, I do. Do I think that you need to do this extra coloring? No. I think you would still have a beautiful card if you did not go in there with alcohol markers. But I can't help it, y'all. I love the dimension. I need it. I need it in my life. So I'm not going to completely cover up all of the shading that we have done. I'm just going to go in and accentuate. Why can't I talk? Accentuate the shapes. So I'm going to go in, I'm putting my darkest color right into those crevices of the pumpkin, and then I am doing just a little bit of flicked color kind of along each section, and then I'm going to blend those out with my next two lighter colors. Again, I did not completely cover up the stenciling. This is just a way that's going to give them more dimension with a little bit of bolder shadows. And then it will also give me the opportunity to kind of blend those lines in a bit more, which makes me happy. This is definitely, it still looks like a no-line coloring look, which is different for me because y'all know I love my bold black outline. But I don't know, I guess in order for me to feel like they felt like a little bit more modern, I didn't want to do the black outline. So yeah, let me know what you think. Do you black outline, no black outline? What do you prefer? Tell me your thoughts. And then what, so I'm going to go through, I'm going to do all of these just like I did the first one. Life, what's going on with life? So I did tell you guys about what had been going on with Molly, and her kennel cough. Just to, you know, briefly summarize that, we've had it for a while. We've done the x-rays. It's not pneumonia, all that jazz. And so where I last left you was I had talked to a friend who was a vet tech, and she had suggested, you know, maybe doing a nebulizer or, doing the laryngeal wash. So I've called around to some vets and I can't find one that does either. But I did in my research online, I'm probably going to butcher this pronunciation. I saw where they talked about like just doing the steam, like just like you would with a baby that had like the croup, you would take them into a steamy bathroom and let them, you know, breathe in that steam to help break up, mucus and stuff in their lungs. So they suggested that. And then the other thing they suggested is called Coupage. It's C-O-U-P-A-G-E. So you pronounce that however you want. Or if you know better, correct me. I'm open to that. I'm teachable. And that's basically where you, like, with cupped hands, kind of, like, it sounds terrible, like smack them, but you're not doing it, not to hurt them, just firmly kind of pat them with cupped hands, and it can break up the secretions in their lungs. Much as like you would hear for, you know, like people doing that with, like when COVID was first a thing. But it's the same kind of idea. Let's talk about the card again. So here, I wanted to do the background. I wanted it to be gold, but I didn't want it to be like picture perfect. I wanted it to be a bit more subtle. So here's what I came up with. I'm using this circle leaf stencil. The circle portion will be covered up and basically it will just leave me with a background. I'm using a finger dauber and the antique gold pigment ink from Altenew. And I'm not doing this perfectly, as you can see. Some areas are, you know, have a bit more gold. Some have a bit less. I'm just kind of tapping it all over. Yes, this is sped up. I'm not this fast of a finger dauberer. But So this way, it would give me two different kinds of gold. So it would give me a soft gold, it would give me a strong gold, and then an even stronger gold. I'm just going to take some of this gold embossing powder. Altenew has a great one, so does Hero Arts. I use both of them. You can't go wrong with either one. But I just sprinkled it on in kind of bits and pieces, and wherever it landed, it landed. Wherever it stuck, it stuck. I didn't even pre-treat this with an anti-static tool because I don't want the background to be perfect. So some of these areas are embossed gold. Some of them are just the gold pigment ink, but it gives this really fun kind of softer look to the background that's more like antiqued or more vintage, which I really enjoy. The overall card, I'm not 100% sold on. You guys know I'm just being transparent. This is different from what I normally do, but I do think that it is kind of the way the industry is leaning a little bit, and so I thought it would be fun to give it a try, and it was fun. It was enjoyable. So what you saw me doing there was, I don't love a white outline. This is not a state secret. So I just went in with a navy and filled in my outlines. You do have to be a bit more careful when you don't have that black outline as a buffer, but totally doable without stressing out too much. And then I am going to heat emboss my gold sentiment on this sand cardstock from Hero Arts. I do have some regrets about this. I don't think you can see the sentiment as well as you would have been able to if I would have done it on the nautical cardstock, like the background. So I wish maybe that I had done that. But all in all, it is still legible, especially when it catches it in the light. But that would be an option if you wanted a more subtle background, but like you liked the gold look, is to put it on like, this is sand from Hero Arts, but you could put it on a craft or something like that where the gold would kind of blend more into the background and it wouldn't be as obvious as it is on the nautical cardstock on the navy color. So once that was done, I die cut it out with the coordinating die, and now we're going to start building. So this panel was cut to 4 by 5 1/4, so it's slightly smaller than my card base, which is that same sand color. And then for the pumpkins, I did die cut out 2 more of those, like the same pumpkin pieces but without the stamping, so that I could stack these up and give them a bit more weight. So Molly, like the cup, we'll do maybe try the cupping technique and see if that's helping. But one of you, super helpful. I always appreciate your guys' feedback because, you know, you have your own lives and experiences. And, you know, I appreciate when you share that with me. One of you had said that your dog had kennel cough, but it took like somewhere between 8 to 12 weeks for them to kick the cough. And so sometimes there really isn't anything else you can do. And so that's helpful to know that other people have had this experience where their dogs just couldn't kick the cough. She is not coughing up as much. We are still playing musical bedrooms so that we can use the humidifier and sleep with the dogs. And so that way she still is getting that as well. I think I will try the little shower steaming as well as the tapping, cupping, to see if that gets us a little bit further along in the progression of things. So wish us luck. Yeah, so that's that. What color are these? I'm thinking to myself because I'm about to show you these embellishments, but I cannot remember what color they are. And these are, this is just my own little like cup thing that I picked up. They're bronze. They're beautiful bronze rhinestones. These are actually from Trinity Stamps. I love their little free-floating, like, flat-backed rhinestones, and I thought that this was a nice, good, neutral color to use to accent the sentiment without bringing in even more gold, since we do have quite a bit of gold. And then this is the whole card. So I hope that you guys are inspired by this. Let me know what you think about the background. Let me know, what you think about just the overall feel of it. Somebody had said it gave like Cinderella vibes, which maybe it does. But yeah, so thank you guys so much for your time. I always appreciate you, and I will catch you on the next video. Bye.